What we've talked about so far concerning the power of God has to do with Jesus and during his time while he was here on earth, and even while he was with his disciples, we see this power of God flowing in the disciples. It's flowing through Jesus, and it was flowing through the disciples to heal the sick, to cast out devils, to raise the dead. You know, every sickness, every disease was taken care of. How? By the power of God. Well, the Bible tells us that we shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost comes upon us. Amen? And so we need to know that the apostles, after Jesus was gone, still had that same power to get the job done. Now, I want you to look at Acts chapter 5, and beginning with verse 12. Acts chapter 5, beginning with verse 12. And it said, "And by the hands of the apostles were many signs and wonders." And you have to understand, this is after Jesus is gone, okay? "By the hands of the apostles were many signs and wonders wrought among the people. And they were all with one accord in Solomon's porch." One accord, if you understand being in perfect agreement, it's where the power is when they were in agreement not only with themselves, but mainly they were in agreement with God's Word. The Bible says, "How can two walk together unless they be agreed?" in Amos 3 and 3. And so we need to know that we have to walk in agreement with God, in agreement with His Word says, in agreement with what He wants us to have, and then we'll walk in that power. See? So they were all in one accord in Solomon's porch. In verse 13, it said, "And the rest, there's no man joined himself to them, but the people magnified them." In other words, the people talked about how big and how mighty things were happening. You know, when you magnify God, you look at Him through a magnifying glass and it gets bigger, right? You look at a problem through a magnifying glass, it gets bigger. But you don't want the problem to get bigger. You want God to get bigger. See, and no matter what kind of situation we have, when we go into the Word of God, the problem will shrink and God will get bigger. Amen? Now, verse 14, it said, "The believers were the more added to the Lord, multitudes, both men and women." Well, Peter's first sermon, you see, actually it was his second sermon, but the first sermon that he preached with the power of God released unto the people, other than the 120 when they were in prayer, but whenever he released that power unto all the people, there were 3,000 people came to Christ. Now that's power. Amen. And then, again in chapter 4, 5,000 more came to Christ as he's preaching and ministering the Word of God. There's power in the Word. You understand that? There's power in the Word of God. The gospel is the power of God unto salvation. And salvation means deliverance, safety, preservation, healing, wholeness, soundness of mind and body, plus eternal life. Now, so the believers here were more added to the Lord, multitudes, both men and women. Verse 15, insomuch that they brought forth the sick. See, they're bringing the sick people into the street and laid them on beds and couches, that at least the shadow of Peter passing by might overshadow some of them. Well, that was not Peter's black shadow, you know, from the sun. That shadow was that overshadowed them was the same overshadowing that overshadowed Mary whenever the seed of life was imparted into her and Jesus was conceived in her. That overshadowing was the same overshadowing on the Mount of Transfiguration when God came down and talked with Jesus and the three inner circle disciples. Amen. And so this overshadowing is the Holy Ghost that's radiating out with the power of God to set people free. So they were wanting people to get close enough to Peter that just passing by, that shadow or that overshadowing would reach out and heal them. Verse 16, it said, there came also a multitude out of the cities round about unto Jerusalem. So people were coming from everywhere in the country and round about, and it said, bringing sick folks and them which were vexed with unclean spirits. So there were sick people and people that were vexed with unclean spirits. And it said, and they were healed, watch this, every one. They were healed, every one. How were they healed? They were healed by this overshadowing. They were healed by this power, the power of God unto salvation. They were set free by the power of God. Amen.